A great delusional error is found in the famous double slit experiment, a new foundation to work upon, a link to unify physics, for light photons only. Particle physicists assume there must be particles because waves can only pass through another. Here we will find that is not always the case. The double slit ends up with spooky, unreal concepts like the universe only exists as a product of our consciousness, multi-universes, and how a cat in a box is both dead and alive. A superposition duality illusions results in misinterpretations and delusion. The double slit demonstrates a limitation of the ability of the observer to predict experimental results. Richard Feynman called it a phenomenon which is impossible to explain in any classical way. It contains the only mystery of quantum mechanics. Blunder in double slit experiment. Misinterpretation of duality. Groundbreaking work for a new interpretation of the double slit experiment. The concept of duality got on the wrong track at the time of the Copenhagen interpretation in the late 1920s, resulting in conclusions of unreality. This disclosure redefines superposition and interference in such a way which corrects the conclusions that result in illogical unreality concepts. A key point in this article is what would cause the intensity become four times greater during the constructive interference of light. In nearly all the explanations today, the intensity is left out, is important, and should be included in all presentations of the single and double slit. When the intensity is evaluated during the assembling or forming of the slit, the terms describing interference such as constructive, destructive, or annihilation become not only misleading but incorrect. Instead, light impinges or collides at the slit, redirecting and fanning out into the interference pattern. We're going to prove that today. Physicists have worked out through mathematics ways to explain the four times intensity. However, it is unreal. The intensity adding to four is known already, but no one has taken the time to fully analyze how and why. The human mind is confused and blocked by the concept of superposition, where waves always pass directly through another. If you look closer at this step by step, you will arrive at the correct conclusion and the weird mysteries of the double slit will dissolve away. Without this new concept presenting here, the double slit is, as Richard Feynman stated, a phenomenon which is impossible. It's all based on an error that should never have happened. It's not something that can be solved by sitting in a chair at a desk cranking out numbers. You must get your head and hands into something more concrete. Realism has replaced reality with the double slit experiment and all kinds of philosophical, illogical arguments have arisen. Realism and reality are different concepts. The theory for the double slit has realism, meaning that concepts exist independently of the observer. Bear with me a little further. How can all these weird unreality concepts come from the double slit? Examples of unreality conditions arriving from the double slit all can be debunked. Google double slit to see how many unreal nonsense, illogical arguments, and ideas came to be. Where did it go wrong? Let's put the double slit back on track. Starting with single edges, let's break it down into sections to see where it went wrong. Okay, on the right is the resulting line from a laser beam striking the left edge of a razor blade. Here it's hit the left edge, and this will be a slit when we close it. Okay, and below is a similar line from the right edge only. So we only got the right edge only. Okay, now we're going to combine the two lines together by closing the slit and making a single slit. Okay, so now we place the two lines on top of each other, just as I said, two edges are simply placed side by side. That puts the two lines on top of each other. Okay, four times brighter. The two lines try to go over another, but they cannot, and a pattern of dashes is formed instead. Common sense would say that the brightness of a fringe would simply double. Instead, we get four times the intensity and dark spaces. Present theory answers this in an unrealistic way. Logic would say that the missing light from the dark fringe has moved into the bright fringe, increasing the intensity to four, not two. The only realistic answer is the two lines have collided and found new paths. The waves can only collide once unless they again strike another edge. EM waves can appear to be particles because they can either collide or pass through another. Superposition has another attribute we have been overlooking. The concept applies to the double slit as well. It's not a wave appearing somehow to be a particle, but waves that collide. The collision of two waves makes a photon appear like a particle. Because superposition infers that two waves always pass through each other, they should never appear as particles. But if somehow one could get two waves to collide, they would temporarily appear to have the attributes of two solid objects colliding. Thus, the experiment can be altered to either collide or pass directly through another. Varying the experiment turns the collisions on or off. This is how people are fooled into duality. Reality, the two waves can either collide or pass through depending on the circumstances. Photons are only waves that can be forced to collide like particles. They're only temporarily appearing like particles. Without this understanding, wild, unreal concepts develop. It's a simple fix, and the math to calculate the interference pattern still works. The photoelectric effect. This short disclosure suggests that a wave can knock an electron out of material. Particles are not required. There is still a quantum effect, but there are only waves, which some errantly believe the waves are particles too. The photoelectric effect does not need particles. A wave can do the same thing. The photoelectric effect does not need to support the particle theory of light. Wave-to-wave collisions takes its place. Conclusion: we have been deluded by an illusion. In another video, photons are forced to collide head-on and shown to directly bounce apart. This is important. A precisely aligned Michelson-Morley interferometer, when the legs are precisely adjusted at D1 equals D2, and this is a very difficult precision alignment, reveals a head-on collision of light waves. The light has an absolute total head-on collision where no light reaches the screen and all the energy bounces back into the laser. A blackout at the screen occurs. Okay, I have that video on my webpage. There are differences when the medium changes from water to photons and then to electrons. Unlike photons, which collide in waterways, the water from the destructive region sloshes into the constructive regions. That could be written better. Okay. Regarding electrons, a revision is required for the electron, which appears to be a particle that leaves a wake. The wake is on a field that was rejected over 100 years ago. These conclusions cannot be directly arrived at solely through mathematics. and experimental history and all corresponding accepted and rejected ideas must be reevaluated. A maze, something that was not possible before this time. Interference is a natural phenomenon happening all the time, at every edge, even with white light. See the white light. Okay. I have an associate degree in engineering, and this does not require rocket science to figure out. Okay. Please respect my long labors on this endeavor. The professors teach their students, and the students ask questions. The questions of the students plant thoughts in their professors' minds, which the professors build upon and get the credit. We're all students. Okay, what I'm going to point out here now is, here's what's presently going on with how they calculate the path. It's done by path-like difference. When it's destructive, the path-like difference to the screen is calculated as a destructive point. Instead, and that comes out of the correct answer, of course, but instead there's collisions between the slit, and that causes a redirection of the photons, okay? Over here is the, this is the white light interference, and this is a paper box. And in here, we have a slit, and that's just a paper box. Okay, here's what happens when you pass white light through it. I hope this thing could be shown better. Okay, now we got, here we have, that's the paper box I showed you right here. Okay, just a piece of paper, and that's how big the groove is. Okay, and it's sitting on top of a cardboard box case. Okay, the lights, the white light, incandescent, and here's the shadow. And right here is an interference pattern, and it shows both. This is just white light. There's a collision occurring in here of the photons. And the path is redirected, and you get an interference pattern right there. You can see a dark edges, bright and dark edges. Also, we got a similar thing with a razor blade. There's a lot. This is laser lens, a razor blade, and the screen. Okay, present theory explains the pattern by the path length difference. So when you measure the difference between one point to the other, if it's off by a half wave, it's destructive interference. And so the wavelets are coming in from this side, and they're more or less curved and out, not totally lined up. When they hit the barrier, it flattens out. The last one flattens out, and they squeeze together and elastically bounce apart. And they shoot out, redistribute, and fan out into the pattern. That's this impinge theory I'm explaining. Okay, if it was the present theory, you would have interference. You would show something in between here, the positive and negative, as they interfere. Okay. Instead, you end up with a pattern like this. This is the pattern. That's the horizontal pattern. That's this one here going this direction. I cut off this part of it, only the end. Here's the setup. You can look up, there's several versions of this fanning out. And that's the interference pattern on the wall. And this is a horizontal
layout of it. So this is the plate. I cut off the center section because it's too bright. Okay, this is it with the room lights on. Now we've got the interference is on the wall. There's a flat plate, and this flat plate is this image right here. This is the flat plate. Okay, there's the, this is actually reflection off the flat plate. This is actually the pattern right here. That one right there, the long one. Okay, this is horizontal to the beam. There's nothing interfere, no pattern in here like you see with water waves. Okay, and you can also take a piece of tape, a long piece of tape, I have a video of that, and run it between these two all the way to the slit, and it doesn't affect this. It doesn't affect the pattern. So nothing's crossing across these areas, the dark areas. Nothing's crossing across the dark area. So there's something wrong with the current theory. Here's the apparatus for splitting the laser beam in half, the interference pattern in half, like this photograph shows. There's the tape. Okay, here's green diode. I'm splitting a wire, but the double slit makes no difference. I checked it already. Okay, and then here's the tape. Okay, the room's a little messy, but it's just a long board. It's like, there's the tape. And that splits the beam, the interference pattern, and I got a photograph of it. Okay, that's the screen. I don't know if you can see the pattern's already been photographed. Okay. Okay, that's the, that's all there is to it. Long board, it's like 16 feet long, plus about 3.5 feet. The splitting part's 16 feet long, so it can't get to either side of this piece of tape. So it invalidates this drawing because the tape separates the two interference fringes. So it points to wave collisions at the obstacle. Second beam splitter for the second screen. There is a second screen. No one shows the second screen, but it should be on there. And what it is, it's right here. That's the second screen, and it's located just the laser, the light goes through the pinhole or through the hole, and then it's normal for the light to hit the mirror, both mirrors, and reflect back. If you look at the mirrors, that's what's going to happen. The light's going to end up going back to the source. Okay. This is normal for the light to go back to the source. However, what is unusual at the second screen is that the fringes are the reverse or negative of the main screen. So right here I have the main screen. That's the main screen. And over here I have the second screen. That, if you look closely, the images are reversed. Now I'll try to get a black spot in the center. That's about as dark as it's going to get. Okay. I have a bright spot in the center. Over here. So, they're reversed. Okay, when the interferometer is critically aligned with only one circular spot appearing at the main screen, as found in the MIT video, where did the light go?
Here's the reference for it. I'm going to insert the video in here now.
The left on the screen then is associated with the light that's returning to the source. The spot on the right is the spot that we looked at before. That's the one that's coming through this lens. And then we've added...
Okay, in the MIT video's case, the photons have hit absolutely directly head-on. Only in this case, all the light has managed to bounce directly back to the source, and the main output screen becomes totally dark. This proves there are collisions in effect. This only occurs with absolute precise alignment, which I am unable to attain here. So you have to watch the MIT video.